Remember how the first ever use of CGI reflection mapping in a film was to create a certain metallic sci-fi vehicle? Well, ever since then, I get suspicious whenever I see metallic sci-fi vehicles in the news. Like this super cool robot exoskeleton called The Method, supposedly being built by South Korean future technology company Hanguk Mirae Technology, which in Korean means Korea Future Technology. Look at those pristine, shiny, perfectly lit mechanical parts. It has to be a computer-generated rendering, right? Well, it's not. It actually exists! Yes, already in its second iteration, this magnificent robot suit may be helping humans work in hazardous environments by late 2017, according to the company's CEO, Yang Jin Ho. And according to Popular Mechanics contributor David Grossman, it could soon see action in the DMZ between South and North Korea. DMZ stands for Demilitarized Zone, David. The point is, the robot is real, so thank you, everyone, and goodbye forever. Or, I bet I could disillusion you anyway. Let's look closer, past the flattering articles and amused billionaires.
Why am I feeling so much like Sigourney Weaver?
At exactly what has been accomplished here. HM are in their third year of prototyping a robotic design informed purely by popular science fiction. And while Boston Dynamics test generation after generation of robots without any regard for how terrifying they look until they perfect their functionality, hey, come on. One of HM's first steps has been to hire a Hollywood concept artist to help design the Method's appearance.
Vitaly Bulgarov
has created concept art for hit video games and films like Transformers Age of Extinction and Ghost in the Shell Age of Okay, Not Great, and he's made this thing look pretty awesome. But a nicely kid-bashed hull and cool interior backlights don't help with the major technical hurdles the robot has yet to overcome. Note how there's almost never a person inside when the unit is shown taking steps. Even with tethers above, it's not yet deemed safe to have the arms and legs operating together, probably because the robot isn't technically walking. It's a pre-programmed sequence of movements, not adaptive behavior controllable in real time. I don't think it's equipped to actively fight for balance big dog style. Stop that! Same with the Method's hands. Right now, their motion is canned and purely decorative. The only thing actually controlled by the pilot is the movement of the arms, achieved through one-to-one motion replication. This approach was used to get an animated baby Herman to hold a live-action cigar in Who Framed Roger Rabbit back in 1988, and to puppeteer the life-sized animatronic T-Rex in Jurassic Park in 1993. And both of those rigs were among dozens of other revolutionary mechanical effects achieved with a small portion of those films' respective budgets. Hanguk Mirae is working with a budget of $200 million to build one robot. And judging by the cables trailing behind it, computer control may not be on board yet. If a couple machines and technicians are still needed on the outside to help this thing move, then it doesn't seem like a robot that could be ready for industry by the end of 2017 to me. But I'm not a robotics expert. So let's ask Brian Gregory, principal engineer at the PTR Group, a company involved, among other things, in developing high-end robotics for NASA's Satellite Servicing Projects Division. Hi, Brian.
Hey, Captain D. Big fan. I'm excited to talk to you.
I know, right? So this Method robot is pretty limited, huh?
Well, yeah, I'd be concerned. For instance, when it waves its arms around, it's pretty unstable. And the center of gravity shifts would interfere with its walking.
In other words, this thing is basically garbage.
Well, no, I wouldn't say that. I eventually see it as some kind of show robot, you know, like a monster truck rally thing, not really a military or construction kind of thing.
All right, okay, but would it be fair to say this project is an insult to the entire field of robotics research?
No.
Why not?
You seem to be personally offended by this robot, Captain.
Well, Brian, let me ask you this. If you were some sort of big hero and parts of you happen to be chrome, and then some company started building a robot that was just as big and heroic and also happened to have chrome parts, wouldn't you be justified in feeling just a little bit insulted?
I'm sure that's not what they're trying to do.
This thing is not taking my job, Brian. Not in a million years, okay? I'm a natural Chrome. Now, what are we going to do about this? Does your team know their team?
Maybe you guys can. I've got to go.
Let's get into it. I need a plan of action.
I got a call coming in.
Don't you hang up on
me. There's a robot.
Brian,
oh,
I need your help. Brian, don't.
I gotta go.
He's gone. Look, industrial robotic arms, large animatronics, and human-piloted machines are all proven concepts. The job of the method is to prove they can all work together in this form factor. And it hasn't done that. Until it can balance itself, negotiate obstacles, or pick up objects, it's just a shaky assembly of moving parts, impressing us purely through pareidolia, because it looks vaguely like a person, or a thing we've seen in a cartoon. So even though it's not a CGI hoax, the method is not really the machine it's claimed to be either. Not like these things. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go find the guy who keeps doing that and give him a taste of his own medicine.